This is Sal again, and this is part four on the series that we're doing at Stanford Medical School with Dr. Connolly.
All right, Sal, we're back here again. This is now the fourth of the slides, and this would be now the business for why that segment of colon was removed. This is the colon cancer.
Wow.
And so just to orient, we'll go now to the drawing, which is, like you were saying before, up here, this is the lumen
right
up here.
Right.
Out here, that's the
lumen is the inside of
the inside.
Right,
that's the inside
of the colon.
Out here, this is the rest of your belly,
right,
where the bowel is all kind of rotating around in the abdomen.
Right.
And
right.
So,
is there a word for like interabdominal?
Yeah, peritoneal.
Peritoneal. Okay.
So
right.
The peritoneal cavity is where all the bowel loops are kind of just
right, just
moseying
around.
Around.
Right,
and
right,
so
right,
they,
right.
And then what we have here is this is the important part, which is this is the muscle,
right,
that allows peristalsis.
Yes, that's the peri. I learned that in high
yeah
school. That's the kind of moving, the undulating motion to push stuff.
Yep,
right.
It'll go and it'll sort of milk it along in order
right
for contents to move along.
Right.
So you can see the muscle looks all fine there. That's
right
how thick it's supposed to be, and it all looks fine over here.
And just on a scale, what scale is this? Like, how thick is that muscle?
And so we're now, once again, our tiny little red blood cells are those little dots there.
Right.
And so we're talking about the thickness here as a few millimeters.
That muscle is
yeah
about a few.
So remember
few
back to this guy, that was about six.
Right.
Millimeters, so that's
right
about six.
Okay. Okay.
Millimeters thick.
Okay.
That's actually strong.
Right.
It's a very
right
very strong muscle, and you can kind of see it goes up here, it kind of comes around here, but it's looking like it's troubled all
yes
along this area.
Yes. And this stuff. This is just this once was probably a polyp, and
mm-hmm
now it's turned into a kind of this massive polyp.
Yeah. So we have the normal over here
right
for the lining. This is where it's going dysplastic.
Right.
Looking
right
a little bit bad there. There's where it's going dysplastic. And so now what happens is you've got these edges of dysplasia.
When people in the medical
up
field say plastic, they're saying that word means tissue?
Well, plastic in general, like plastic
yeah
surgery
right
or the plastics of, as far as a material science, means moldable.
I see.
But it also means you can grow with it or
I
you
see
can change shape.
Right. So when
and
you call something plastic, it's like, it's moldable tissue.
It's the shape changes.
It's the shape, shape
and
changes.
So, and so the shape changes were wrong.
I see.
And actually, dysplasia can refer to a cell, a
I
tissue,
see
an organ, or an entire limb.
Oh, okay.
So
okay
it just means
right
it grew wrong.
I see.
Or molded
see
wrong. So now this is where we have the cell dysplasia. This is all the bad stuff.
Right.
And it basically started probably somewhere up there and is invading in
right
all of these directions.
Just one cell up there just started dividing uncontrollably.
That's right.
And
it could have started from one cell being very bad. It often, though, starts, and I'm going to change now, so we're going to lose our art.
Okay.
And so what I'm going to do is change is that it often starts, though, from one of these.
Right.
Meaning maybe a cell went bad right around there, and
right
now really is starting to
it's
grow.
And when you say grow, it's not just one cell. It's all of its descendants.
It's its descendants, and billions
right
of cells
right
are growing in order. Billions and billions are growing
yes, yes
downward in order
right
to now,
right
in this case, grow all the way through.
Wow.
And so you can see the scale
yeah
is it not only grew a little bit, it went right through the muscle.
Yeah, wow.
Okay, so going back to this guy here, this is now.
And there are some, like, the body does have things to fight this off, but it was unsuccessful.
That's right. And so there are certain conditions where if you decrease the immune functions,
right,
you'll get cancer.
I see.
And
right
so it's still argued, though, whether it's that your immune system was decreased, you got a virus, and
right
then the virus caused the cancer,
right,
or whether there's a lot of surveillance
right
to eliminate cancer.
And that
cancer
whole notion that viruses, I mean, it's fascinating. It's because viruses are messing with our, sometimes, they, I mean, isn't a significant chunk of our own DNA from ancient viruses? And
yeah, yeah. And I think there's a couple of big categories is that viruses can get into your DNA
right
and really screw up the DNA
right
by getting
right
you know, integrated into it. But they also, like we said before, can lead to irritation.
Right,
and then
right
more cell
right
growth and have
that
troubles
sense
there.
Makes sense.
So now we're back here in which we're looking at the cancer, which probably, like you said, started here and is growing, including spreading out all the normal tissue around it.
Wow.
And so we're going to look now at the cells. So
zoom in.
Zoom time. Hang on to your hat.
Yeah.
Okay, so what we're going to do is first probably go into a lower power here, is look at the edges of this. So once again, we find normal.
Right.
And so this is even not perfectly normal. You can see it's a little bit dividing and a little bit irritated.
Right.
So this
right
is irritated along the edge.
Hyperplasia.
Exactly.
Yeah, look,
exactly.
I'm learning something.
All right. So then what we have now is as you go in deeper, these are the areas where it's normal, but this is all kind of coming out, you know, like we're saying up here, kind of growing out in all directions.
Right.
This is now where you can see the cancer next to the normal. You know, we had talked before about dysplasia. This is really bad.
Right. And so, capital D.
Yep. Small children off the street could be able to tell you that this is bad.
Right.
And so when
after they watch this video.
Yeah,
after,
exactly.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And so these are the normal ones. They're doing their J-O-B job.
Right.
Making the mucin, nuclei at the bottom. What is this guy doing?
Right. It's just
chaos.
Yeah.
So before we talked about carcinoma in situ, a cancer in spot, if you saw cells this bad, you'd say, do not let them go far.
I see.
Because they will have a tendency to invade. They're crazy. So this right here is a bunch of the cells. That's a bunch of the cells. They're these guys here. You can see they're really haphazard. They're growing. They're not doing their.
So if we found a polyp that had this stuff that didn't cross that boundary line yet, we still would say no. We got to take this. You know. Well, I guess we already took it out.
You took it out. Cancer of the colon is one of the ones where surgical cure is still a classic.
Right.
Cut it out, and you're probably in pretty good shape.
Right.
And so there you'd say, well, if it's the tip of the polyp and it looked like this, I think we got it out. But you'd say to yourself, we better watch this person.
I see. So if the whole polyp kind of looked like that, you're like, oh, let's cut out a bigger section.
Yeah, then you might. So if it's going down into the neck or getting a little further, or if you cut across it at the margin, then watch out. But here's the problem. Is remember how I said up here it's not a big deal, but once you get down near the veins and arteries, these guys are running amok down by the veins, the arteries.
And so you can actually see these cells have split off.
Yeah.
And so they're infiltrating.
So you can see these guys here. So that's one little nest of cell. There's one. That's probably right there, a cancer cell, just dying to get into that little vein.
Right. So this is actually, I can never say the word,
metastasis.
This is it. We're seeing it.
This is where it would come from.
This is where it's starting to happen.
So these guys are the bad actors. They're growing in next to these very fragile little blood vessels. And so that guy is knocking on the door.
Right.
Once it gets in here, that's a venule, meaning a little vein.
Right.
That's the road out.
Right. And it just looks like a circle here because it's a two-dimensional cross-section of it. But you can imagine it popping in or out of our screen.
Yeah, so it'd be popping in our screen. So this guy would kind of go in and out of the screen, connect to this one, and then it would go out.
And it's officially, I can never say the word metastasized, once it's found a beachhead someplace else?
That's right. So it's considered a metastasis where, let's say, the cell got into the vessel.
Right.
If it left the region.
Okay.
So it went to the lung,
I see. But
the liver.
This is looking like it's
This is looking this like looking you really are worried that this could metastasize.
Right.
And so what's interesting about this is that when you look at something like this, there's such a thing called, for cancer, grade.
Right.
And what grade is basically what we've been just talking about. How bad does that look?
Right, right.
And so the grade is, wow, that looks nasty.
Right.
I think that
is nasty a technical term?
Actually, we use it quite a bit.
Okay.
See, people say, well, that tumor show, we said it was nasty. When we talk about nastiness, it's a lack of behavior. If you can get a cell where the nucleus gets that big, or sometimes it's that big, there's chaos.
Right.
And there's chaos not just in nuclear size, but how it behaves.
And I guess the nuclear size is what is a telltale, because that means that the cell is devoting a lot of its resources for replication and
it's replication, but it also means to me that normally things in the cell are very orderly.
Right.
You do not divide your DNA until these things are all right.
I see.
About
and
the
now
cell.
It's just doing it.
And now
and
it's just left and right. So yeah, this would be a high grade tumor.
Wow.
And then stage is the other main thing.
Yes, I've heard of stage.
Stage means where is it in the body?
Right.
So in this case, if it's these nasty cells and at the very top, it's actually a lower stage than if they're nasty cells and they've come all the way down here.
So in situ carcinoma would still get a stage.
It's a stage zero.
Stage zero.
So it's basically you're nowhere. And then if you begin to just cross over like here and invade, then you're to be stage one. And then there are depths as you go for stages. And then there's always the other thing where did it go off to other parts of your body?
Right.
And that's the very highest stage.
And so this isn't a and this is true of all cancers. When people talk about breast cancer, I've heard it in that context a lot, stage one, stage zero through four. Mm-hmm. And so it isn't just the size. So if the cancerous tissue is big, but if it's in a safe place, it could still be stage one or stage zero.
It is. What's interesting about staging is almost the whole world has agreed to do the same kind of staging.
Right.
And that staging is what we're calling TNM. And T has to do with how big it is
right.
in the one site and how much it's crossed any barriers.
Right.
So this would
but
be
the barrier crossing sounds like the most important thing.
It does, although this one here is, are they in lymph nodes?
Oh, right, right.
And the lymph nodes are nearby structures where, you know, the lymph goes.
Right.
And so that's one road out. And the other one is metastases.
Right.
And so, yeah, the staging has to do with all three.
I see. I mean, metastases always happens through the circulatory system, through the blood, the vessels, or does it also happen through the lymph network?
And so it's something where going through the lymph nodes for something like this is one of the first steps.
Right.
But getting to the liver and the lung, it's got to get into the blood vessels somehow.
I see.
Lymphatic in your colon
right.
connects to a local lymph node,
right.
but does not connect through lymph only to the lung.
I see.
So it must have gone into the blood somewhere.
I see.
So that's the way it looks here. And then the final thing here when looking at this cancer is if we go over here, this is the greatest depth of invasion. You'd ask me about the body's immune function. Well, if you look here, now you see how it's kind of loose and there are all these little immune cells? That's what these guys are. Those are
What's the immune cell?
These guys here. See the little round guys? Those are lymphocytes.
So actually, if you circle it,
Yeah.
Like how can you tell the difference between the lymphocytes and the cancer cells?
It's because I'm a pathologist.
You've had many years of training.
No, but they're the little round ones. So this one right here is a classic cell, which is called a plasma cell, in which there's a nucleus here, and all the rest of this is making antibodies.
You're not circling that area, are you?
No, I'm not. I'm just drawing.
Oh, okay,
I'm just drawing.
Right.
So this guy is this one. I drew him right.
You're zooming in on
yeah,
this.
Yeah, zooming
right.
on that. Right. So, yeah, that's a plasma cell,
right.
meaning it's a nucleus.
I just want to clarify what you've circled there, just because it could be a little bit confusing. This big circle is maybe we should.
This is why I should leave it to the pros.
No, just because I'm getting confused. So, you're not circling that area.
I'm not doing that.
What it looks like zoomed in.
Right. That's a plasma cell.
That's a plasma cell. Right.
That's making antibodies probably against the tumor.
So
that's the immune response in that spot.
And how do you know that's – I mean, that looked very similar to the cancer cells.
This one's a little hard to tell. If you had a real microscope, you'd turn up the light and it would have a very specific look to the nucleus.
Okay.
And then these guys over here have little pink granules in them,
right.
which is a type of immune cell. And then so when looking through here –
Which ones are cancers here?
Okay. So now let me just get over here to this one here and then come out just a little bit. Let me go over here. Is that when looking at these guys, these are all inflammation. The nearest cancer cell where I could bet the farm are these guys up here.
Oh, okay. See, when you see on this view, it becomes more obvious. They definitely look different.
They look different. So then when you come out here, you can see there's the cancer.
Right.
This is the body's reaction to the cancer right there.
I see.
At the
Amazing.
Deepest zone. And there are therapies based on trying to get more of this
wow.
immune response.
That's amazing. Very cool.